Hey everyone, and welcome to Top Think. Today, we're going to learn about what would happen if someone built a conscious computer virus. Now, let's begin. As we close in on the discovery of artificial intelligence, well-known figures like Elon Musk and the late Stephen Hawking have been sounding an alarm. They've said over and over again that AI isn't something to look forward to. It's something to be genuinely scared of. In their minds, it's well within the realm of possibility that our artificial creations could turn against us. Now, how long will it take for our AI to become more intelligent than humans? When they realize how much smarter they are, will AI treat humans like inferior beings? Will their existence bring an end to all of humanity? It's a bit of an exaggeration, I know. However, that's the gist of the terrifying future that many experts are worried about. But let me ask you this. How could one conscious robot lead to the downfall of an entire species? Well, one solution comes in the form of a conscious computer virus. That's an artificial mind that's capable of replicating itself. Much like a biological virus, this AI would spread from host to host by creating copies of itself. Then that copy would develop its own copies, and each of those copies would make more copies until it exists on a global scale. Hypothetically, a computer virus with that much power could overthrow such a technologically reliant civilization pretty easily. But is that a realistic fear, or is this concept better suited to the pages of a sci-fi novel? Well, before we dive into the practicality of a conscious computer virus, we have to address one very important question, and that is, what makes something conscious? The truth is, there are dozens, if not hundreds, of different answers. Some are simple and narrow, and others are radical and will probably shatter all your preconceived notions about human consciousness. With so many options to choose from, which definition is the most accurate? Unfortunately, it's almost impossible to say. We don't have enough information yet, but we are getting closer. Psychologists, philosophers, and other scientists are constantly conducting new research and making enlightening discoveries. For example, a group of neuroscientists recently proposed that your conscious mind exists as an electrical field surrounding your brain. Now, is that possible? Yes. Is it accurate? No one really knows for sure. But at this rate, it won't be long before we're able to definitively unravel the mysteries of organic consciousness. Until then, we need some kind of working definition. So for the time being, let's just say this. To be conscious is to be aware of your existence within an environment. Consciousness is your ability to differentiate yourself from the external world. That individuality gives you a number of unique privileges. Conscious beings have the potential to experience. They can perceive. They can feel. They can create an identity and a sense of self. Okay, for this to make a bit more sense, take this relatively mundane set of questions. How does it feel to sit down and watch this video? What is it like to experience the sound of my voice? Or the colors of this animation? You can answer all three of these questions, or at least I hope so. You can only do that because you're aware of your subjectivity. You're a conscious being who can have unique experiences. Now, while it isn't a component of consciousness, you can even communicate those experiences through language. Yeah, we take it for granted, but this is something that very few organisms are capable of. So, does that mean that humans are one of the only conscious beings in the universe? That depends on who you ask. But most neuroscientists would have to disagree. When people think about consciousness, it's often posed as a yes or no question. You're either conscious or you're not. Consciousness is treated like some kind of magic power that we have over the rest of the world. But what if consciousness is more like a spectrum? Some organisms would be higher on the spectrum, like humans. Others would fall in the middle, like dogs or monkeys. While the majority of organisms would land at the bottom, like flies and earthworms. Now that means every wiggling, dirt-eating invertebrate has some degree of awareness. some small fraction of subjectivity. It sounds counterintuitive, doesn't it? How can you compare these tiny, simple creatures to human beings? To start with, they're not nearly as tiny and simple as you might think. Compared to humans, earthworms really can't do much, but in the grand scheme of things, they're incredibly complex. Their bodies are still comprised of living cells, which form organs, nerves, and a functioning brain. It's very possible that consciousness is just a byproduct of certain complex systems. In other words, when an organism is detailed enough, consciousness comes naturally. So, if earthworms do have a little bit of consciousness, shouldn't we see proof that they're capable of being subjective? Well, actually, we have. Like humans, earthworms have shown that they can make decisions. Studies have found that under identical circumstances, different worms perform different actions. Furthermore, the same worms will make changes to their behavior depending on the situation. Now, this suggests that earthworms can make choices and adapt to the world around them. I'll admit those choices are very simple, like moving a leaf, but they're choices nonetheless. And every choice is connected to some degree of subjectivity because you have to perceive your existence within your environment. Now, assuming that consciousness does develop through sufficient complexity, how does this theory affect the creation of a conscious computer virus? Well, believe it or not, it's actually one of the strongest arguments we have in favor of artificial intelligence. Quite a few neuroscientists are using the internet as an example of how a complex system, despite having no organic parts, can still become semi-conscious. It's no secret that the internet is an immensely detailed creature. I know it's weird to call the internet a creature, but in many ways, it thinks, it functions, and it processes information like a biological organism. Many people have argued that this is only because of humans, and on the surface, they're absolutely right. Humans created the ideas, the language, and the code that allows the internet to exist. But in a sense, that isn't all that much different than passing along genes through reproduction. You certainly wouldn't say that a child is not conscious because they were born from the pieces of their parents. It's true that the internet would not exist without us. Over the years, could it have still developed at least partial consciousness? Are the millions of people that contribute to the internet like the neurons that power your conscious brain? Probably not. The internet is actually more analogous to the automatic parts of our brain, the unconscious majority that keeps your heart pumping, lungs breathing, and stomach digesting. It's plenty complicated and it's very important, but most people would agree that self-awareness isn't exactly our unconscious mind's area of expertise. It relies on formulaic mechanical behaviors, instincts, impulses, pre-programmed reactions to internal and external stimuli. Your unconscious doesn't really make any intentional decisions. It can't feel or experience anything. If you want proof, try lightly scratching someone while they're sleeping. It would cause a physical reaction. Dead skin cells would fall off. New cells would start repairing the damaged ones. But would they experience you scratching them? Would they feel pain? Nope, they just wake up with a mark on their arm. If the internet is closer to your unconscious than your conscious, then what is it lacking? It's really hard to argue that the internet is not detailed enough to be conscious. So what's the last piece of the puzzle? Consciousness at this point is an intangible concept. It's a frustrating answer, I know, but it's the best one we've got. Consciousness is just something that exists for reasons that we can't understand, at least not yet. So where does that leave our conscious computer virus? At this point, the danger of an artificial takeover is far out of view. It's pretty unrealistic and lacks a stable theoretical framework, but that doesn't mean artificial intelligence isn't dangerous. Let's assume that some sort of machine does gain subjectivity. It begins experiencing and mirrors consciousness. By unlocking conscious thought, the machine starts to outperform humans. Now, like most superior organisms, it's possible that machines will exert their dominance over us. That's assuming a machine would abide by basic evolutionary principles like survival of the fittest. it's impossible to say if or why an AI would feel the need to compete with and destroy humanity. It's more likely that humans and artificial organisms learn to coexist. In fact, many leading experts in both robotics and neuroscience are optimistic about the future of AI. They're less worried about a robot takeover because discoveries rarely change the world so quickly and dramatically. More often than not, the changes are slow and gradual. So that means when someone does create a conscious machine, it will probably fall very low on the overall spectrum. It'll be much closer to an earthworm than a full-fledged human being. In other words, it may be able to perceive and make choices, but they're going to start small. This does, however, open the door for a different kind of threat, because a conscious computer virus is something else entirely. Unlike an AI, if someone created a conscious virus, the goal isn't to replicate humanity. It's to develop an adaptable parasite that thinks just enough to consume and destroy. But whose fault is that? Would you blame an earthworm for eating dirt? Or would you blame the person who put earthworms in your garden? In other words, the idea of robot takeover sounds pretty terrifying. But at this point, we are a much bigger threat to ourselves than even the sophisticated machines. Hey, thank you for watching Top Think, and be sure to subscribe because more incredible content is on the way.